Today I have the pleasure to talk to Steve Daheep. Steve, welcome. Welcome again. Good to have you on the show again. This time on distance. And hopefully next time we can meet in person again.
Yeah, I hope we can meet again soon.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. And the periods will change for sure. You are the Senior Vice President Oracle Cloud. And we see now that cloud has a crucial role in digital transforming companies. It's great that you are willing to share your experience today because you have a ton of experience in this cloud domain. And we see that companies have enormous pressure to digitally transform now, the coming months, the coming year, I think. And cloud plays a crucial role in this. Can you elaborate on this? Can you share some of your experience?
Yeah, absolutely. I think you had set it up perfectly. If you look at what's going on today, companies in every industry are experiencing new realities and in some cases, economic uncertainty. You know, businesses from startups to large enterprises are reacting to changing behaviors and are adapting to rise above these challenges. And things like operating anywhere, the need for elasticity and rapid innovation create an even greater urgency for cloud and, to your point, digital transformation. You know, at the end of the day, cloud allows us to address the economic environment, and we'll talk more about that. It helps us to address business security and resiliency. It allows us to engage with employees and customers in new ways. It allows us to rapidly deliver solutions to market quickly, which is very important given how dynamic things are to market. And then importantly, it also helps us inform decisions as we can collect data and get better insights. Analytics are critical to understanding what's going on in the markets we serve and how we best respond. You know, a couple key points, you know, efficiency and transformations. You know, there's gains there where you can help move customers to cloud. They can leverage capabilities like autonomous AI, machine learning. They can benefit from superior economics and really enhance their overall capabilities. We spoke about this idea of insights and innovation, where we provide tools that provide deeper insights into their business, so their supply chain, their customer, employees. And again, this idea of rapidly being able to create and deploy innovation, you know, extend the capabilities of your company and your offering is a core mandate. You need to be able to meet the pace of this ever-changing landscape that we're all experiencing today. So it's for all these reasons that the urgency of cloud and the acceleration of digital transformation is happening today.
And you were mentioning economics already as an important factor. And I think every organization is now keen to reduce cost, but on the other hand, without impacting the performance, of course. What's your view on this?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. You don't need to compromise. You know, there is this urgency for cloud, for elasticity, for companies looking to get out of the data center business. And, you know, the only issue is people can't afford to pay more for less. You know, when you look at some of these Gen 1 cloud offerings, they are not performing where they could be, and they wound up being extremely expensive. And this was something, you know, to be honest, we were very conscious of when we drove our Gen 2 redesign, which was a completely re-architected network storage and compute infrastructure, to your point, where today we can deliver block storage, you know, 20 times the performance of Amazon at less than half the cost. So greater performance at less than half the cost. We can deliver 2x the performance versus Amazon for general purpose and memory optimized instances. We see this big shift to high performance computing HPC workloads. You know, our cloud is 44% less than Amazon in some of these. So again, you know, you address the performance, as you said, while also paying less for increased performance. And beyond industry-leading performance and price performance, you know, we also deliver the highest levels of security, the highest levels of availability, autonomous operations, and a truly flexible, elastic cloud that delivers on the original promise of cloud. So it's interesting when you have so many companies that are reaping those benefits today. McAfee is a leading security information and management company they transitioned to OCI and they saved more than four times over competitors with a 15 time faster implementation. There's a company like 8x8 who's a leader in secure enterprise meeting solutions. They're obviously growing with the likes of Zoom and others, and they moved from AWS to Oracle and saw an 80% savings on their network egress cost with a 5% increase in performance. Other companies seen 100% increase in performance at half the cost. And the one notable thing is, you know, a lighthouse company like Zoom chose Oracle, and their exact words were, you know, Zoom selected Oracle infrastructure for its advantages in performance, scalability, reliability, and superior cloud security. So being able to deliver that and, to your point, also address the economics is a very powerful and timely value prop for companies today.
Yeah, and as being Dutch, these economics, getting more for less is always important. I did some research. I read in a Forrester report that 82% of the companies want their data strategy to lead, on one hand, better understanding of the customer, and on the other hand, better customer experience. So managing your data properly is crucial. Can you explain the role of cloud in this data management?
Yeah, absolutely. Cloud plays a massive enabler in a data strategy for anybody. I mean, the information is the lifeblood of an organization, the foundation of its decision making, you know, whether that's across internal process optimization, whether that's being able to better understand our customers and meet their needs or support our customers, or even very important today is our employees. Where are they located? How are they doing? So analytics plays a very strong role across that. There are stats that have said that 73% of organizations report that their data is really siloed and disparate and all over the place. Some is on-prem, some is in public cloud, some is in private cloud, and you need to be a way to be able to aggregate all these different data sources, to unify them in a space, and then to apply data management, analytics, data science, and other technologies to that. And that's what we're able to do in a way that's both connecting hybrid cloud, so on-prem with public cloud, as well as multi-cloud and a range of applications that may be on cloud with different data sources that might reside in different locations. So it's about pulling all this data together, housing it in cloud, and then using technologies like autonomous database, data warehousing, machine learning, data science, and others to really get a good understanding. And we have a lot of customers that are doing that today. A company called Western Digital, I think we know all of them, they make a lot of storage products. They moved to an Oracle platform and they cut analytic reporting time down from 8.5 hours to 20 minutes. So think about how fast things are moving in this market today and being able to keep up with that pace of change by getting insights much quicker than you could before. We also have very important companies like CERN, you know, Nobel Prize winning physics research lab, who are facilitating analytics on mission critical data that they collect for more than 2 million signals. So if it works for CERN, you know, it works for an enterprise. And CERN's using the autonomous data warehouse to improve the operational efficiency of all the IoT data that they collect with the goal of accelerating scientific discovery. Company like Vodafone, who is a leading mobile and internet service provider, they were able to reduce the cost, the time it took to build complex reports from 2 weeks to 30 minutes. And so many others that are using it to process information for drug discovery, for research, and for all those things that might have a big impact in today's world. So analytics really is a part of a lot that's going on today. And we're proud that we have a leading solution that supports people as they serve and support others.
Steve, it was great having you on the show again, and as I said, hopefully next time in person again. And for the audience, thank you for watching and see you next time.
Thank you, Ronald.
You're welcome.